Alright. Hi guys. So, last time we killed the Moonlight Butterfly, I believe. So today I think we're going to go through the parish. I think that's what we will do. So we'll go activate the shortcut first and then go through the normal way. Straight through here. So I haven't even uploaded the first episode yet, which I recorded like a month ago. It's what, the 9th here today? So I started this playthrough and then, yeah, recorded one episode and then took a bit of a break. Not really a break, I think I was just went back to Bloodborne a bit. Just been doing a lot of co-op with my friend. It's been fun. Just been doing a bit of a casual playthrough, just leveling up when we want, no restrictions. But it's been fun. It's good to have a playthrough where it's not serious and you just have a laugh and whatnot. Parry skills. God, I hate this guy up here. Oh. Get used to playing Bloodborne. I was just trying to hit that guy again to get a bit of regain. Does feel a lot different though playing this after playing Bloodborne for a good month or so. Did I get that ring? No. Okay. Remember stressing out about this item on my very first playthrough. I had no idea how to get it. The way I ended up figuring out was dropping down from the top. I didn't even think to jump over this way. But I got the item, so I was happy. So I guess the big news circling around is the leaked Dark Souls 3 stuff, which if true is pretty exciting. Oh, I don't want to make the same mistake as Dark Souls 2 and get really pumped up and hyped just to be let down really. So I'm trying to keep my cards close to my chest at this stage. But it is exciting nonetheless. Whoa. It's good to be back to Dark Souls though. I mean, it's probably my favourite game ever. Taken over probably from the Metal Gear series, which I've been playing since Metal Gear first came out, PlayStation 1. It was always my favourite series. I recently downloaded Ground Zeroes on the PS4. It's one of the free games this month. PS Plus. It was pretty good. I mean, it's short, but it was fun. That's the main thing. Ugh. Okay. This crossbow guy has to go. Wonder if I'll get invaded here. Considering I'm online. Probably should have hit the bonfire then, but I didn't really want to respawn all the enemies. That guy's just healed up. Yeah, if I get invaded here, I'm probably going to get wrecked.
Well now, you seem to have your wits about you. Hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Okay, what do we want? How many souls do I have? Okay. Probably want that. Hmm.
Thank you.
I think I used up all my shards. Oh no, I've got a few. Okay, cool. Pop a couple more. Wish you could just pop them all at once. Okay.
I hope you.
Let's see. We want this and this. I do want a rapier, however you want to say it. Do I want a short bow? Yeah, why not? Large arrows.
Oh, thank you. Come back.
I'll grab some more arrows, I think. Might be easier. Let's put these little ones. Yeah, so I think we'll kill Taurus Demon and probably the gargoyles too.
Ow.
Today. Okay. 65. That should be good. I've already got a longbow. Can I even use this? I don't even think I can. No. Okay. Well. When I level up Dex, I'll be able to use it. Been lurking around Twitch lately. Well, not so much lurking, I've been commenting on streams here and there. But I've been watching a lot of Barneezy Jones and DarkLord Sen, a couple of the Soulbrant guys. They're pretty fun to watch. Sen was doing Chalice Dungeons in Bloodborne the other day. I managed to get in and help him fight a boss, which was pretty cool. I mean, it only lasted like 3 minutes, but it's always cool to interact with your favourite streamers. And yeah, watching Barneezy, he was doing Forest Invasions on PS3, so I dropped my red sign, managed to get a few jewels with him. I got wrecked 3 out of 4 times. The one time I did win, I had to resort to dark magic. But I didn't care. I got a win. That was a lot of fun. climb up ladders quicker. Ladders feel so slow in this game. After playing even Dark Souls 2 and Bloodborne. Bloodborne more so, because you don't even use stamina when you fast go up quickly up a ladder. Ooh, could be getting invaded here. I was gonna go get the bonfire. Oh no. Oh, god damn it. Okay, I think we'll just progress through the level. I was going for the Pinhecker. Missed that parry by a mile. Sneaky guy. And here we go. Watch me get wrecked. This guy's probably going to be really OP. He'll probably one-shot me. Okay, where is he? Oh, there he is. What's he doing? Okay, good sir. It's due to the death. What is he even doing? Is he writing a message or? I don't know. What? Seriously, I have no idea what he's doing. God. Well, that was pretty weird. Yeah, at this low level, if I get invaded, they're probably going to be twinking hardcore. They're going to have, like, pretty much max gear. Like, I'll probably almost always get one shot. And if not, my health is probably gonna be all but emptied, I guess. Like, my gear, I'm just, god. It's not even, nothing's upgraded except for my battle axe. I'll just run past these guys. At least I'll be able to hit the bonfire this time. Hello. Whoa. Right, round two. Lucky you got the parry on. Sometimes this guy will follow you if you don't take him out there. Has he dropped? Oh, short sword. I'll also take this guy too. Okay. Oh no, it's a waistcloth. Let's wear it. Actually, let's wear the low warrior helm too. I wonder if I can wear any of the elite knight stuff. No. Leather? Nope. Okay, that'll do. Go up to the top of this tower and get this guy, because he can snipe you from anywhere. And like, even all the way over there too. Can be pretty annoying. Almost pretty embarrassing, actually. What do you got for me? Longsword. Cool, cool. I'll take it. God, this guy completely ruined my day when I was a newbie. His day, so that's good. Ooh, nice. Black Knight sword. I was playing around with my build because I wasn't quite certain on which direction I was going to go, but I did decide to take Dex to 18 so I can use Black Knight weapons. Like, my main will be the Crescent Axe still. Ooh. But yeah, if I want to take this build into PvP and whatnot later on when it's done. I did want a bit more variety, so taking Dex to 18 can open up those Black Knight weapons, so it's always handy to get a early Black Knight weapon. Okay, have a one. Let's see if I can remember how to parry him. Okay. Oh yeah. I'm not going to do a great deal of damage, but it's better than nothing, I guess. You gotta watch because he does a quick one every now and then. It can really catch you off guard. Yeah, I think that might have been it. It was a bit quicker than before. Oh god, I nearly missed that. One more should probably do it. Oh yeah. God, it's so stressful towards the end because he can quite literally one-shot you. Right. There's no ifs and buts about that. I think I might get rid of Red Tear Stone. I might be able to use Elite Knight now. Yep. I wonder if I can use the Gauntlets as well. No, I'm just pushing it. Yeah, that'll do. Let's open this door up. So yeah, all that's left is Taurus and the Crystal Wizard. I'm pretty sure I didn't get the Crystal Wizard in the last episode. And then we'll find out in about 10 seconds. Off. I was hoping to get at least a couple of large shards. Actually, large shards would be better than chunks at this stage. Slot down ladders is a bit different too. I was pressing down and circle at the same time, but you just have to hold circle in. Yeah, let's not plunge attacking this time. It's fighting like a man. No, I've got a. My weapon is probably overpowered. This day. You probably shouldn't even have an upgraded weapon at all in a normal playthrough. Oh, AOE. What do you got? Okay, you're done. Great axe. Pity. I will eventually be able to two-hand the Demon's Great Axe. Taking strength to 40. Draw the dragon out. See what else you have to say.
Oh, aha. So I didn't scare you. I have a proposition, if you have a moment.
Yes.
The way I see it, our fates appear to be intertwined. In a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey?
Sounds like a plan.
Well then, take this.
Thank you.
We are amidst strange beings in a strange land. The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out. The very fabric wavers, and relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact. But use this to summon one another as spirits, cross the gaps between the worlds, and engage in jolly cooperation. Of course, we are not the only ones engaged in this, but I am a warrior of the sun. Spot my summon signature easily by its brilliant aura. If you miss it, you must be blind.
Thanks, bro. What are you going to do now?
Oh, hello there. I will stay behind to gaze at the sun. The sun is a wondrous body, like a magnificent father. If only I could be so grossly incandescent.
Everyone loves Soleil. Though I do remember my very first playthrough, there was a message like right around about here somewhere, and I looked at it and it said attack. So in my newbie state of mind, I thought, well, this guy's obviously evil, I must have to attack him. Little did I know that he was one of the good guys, so I murdered him in cold blood and I felt horrible for it. Need that to 42. I mean, I don't really need the damage at this stage, or the health. I'm pretty content with my abilities. But once I get to 42, I can wear the armor setup I want. And I won't have to worry about that later. Come on, dragon. We want your drinks. First playthrough, see those messages down there under the bridge. I remember firing off like about 300 wooden arrows on his tail with an unupgraded bow. Took me ages to get it, but man, did I want that drake sword. And I got it, and I felt like a god for the next few areas. Good old Drake sword. In all honesty, it's actually not that bad of a weapon, really. I mean, it gets a lot of negative press, I guess you'll say. And it's pretty fun to use, especially the R2. Let's go up here and try and fight this second Black Knight. one's a bit harder than the other one. Oh no. Okay. And that moves fairly easy to parry. Okay, well, God, it's just as easy as the other one. I've got a Black Knight Greatsword. Man. This Black Knight drops at OP at the moment. Okay, we want to rush straight through here. One of those hollows is going to shut the gate and it's kind of annoying to go through the other way. Get wrecked. Nice. I need this kitty for later. Not later on in this episode. Later on in the playthrough. Maybe next episode, actually. There it is. Yeah, that looks pretty funny if you're using a spear type weapon. Their poke on, then it's very annoying. Okay, what do we get? Nice. I doubt I'll be able to use that. Let's have a look. Able to fast roll with it, I would have wore it for the remainder of the episode. Actually wouldn't mind a boulder helmet of these guys. Oh, beautiful. God, my drops have been awesome today. Yeah, because I am planning on using the boulder helm. It's part of my armor setup. So yeah, that was a very handy drop. Yeah, I think we'll just clear this area out. And then hit the bonfire, and then I'll go human. We'll summon Solarian for the gargoyles. Okay, you've got to go. Man, this crossbow gun shoot bolts for days. I think it's been a pretty good run so far. I mean, I died to the invader, but he looked pretty OP, so. Might as well level up. I can only get one anyway, but it all helps. Let's see. Reverse. I'll probably kindle this bonfire too. Because I'm not sure if I want to let the what are they called? The bonfire keepers. I'm not sure if I want to let Lautrec kill her. Or if I want to kill Lautrec straight away and get the Ring of Favour and Protection. Which is another ring I'm going to need in the final setup. But yeah, if I let Lautrec kill the Firekeeper, that's what they're called. I couldn't remember that. The Firekeeper, then the Firelink bonfire is going to be out, so I'm probably going to use the parish as my main hub, so to speak. Shard. So it's good to kindle that one. Ooh. Ugh. There we go. Oh, I didn't get the parry anyway. This room can be pretty tricky. I mean, they're only hollows, but once they're buffed, which they are now, they are really tough. Ooh. See that damage? God, the channeler is... Okay. He's in a really awkward position there. Kind of want him to. Okay, no, I still can't kill him. Okay, now he's dead. Wow, that was really, really, really sloppy. Ooh. Yeah, that attack there, if you get caught in that with no poise, you are done for. They don't even need to be buffed. That can do some serious damage. Especially if it's caught in a, if it's counted as a counter hit too. Oh. So we will go free Lautrec. If anyone does watch this playthrough, let me know if you want to want me to keep him alive, or if you want me to kill him straight away. I really don't mind.
Oh, still human, are you? Then I am in luck. Could you help me? As you can see, I am stuck without recourse.
There we go. Yeah, he's a bit of a dick, but But he does give you a very handy ring, so for that, I thank you, Lautrec. You can actually summon him for this fight too, but Solaire's enough. I mean, you can summon both of them and then just hang back and just, well, watch them just gank the gargoyles. It's pretty funny, but alright, Solaire, let's go, bro. Gargoyles. That tail. He's in a really awkward position, though. Right near the edge. Okay, let's quickly put that up. Those guys, they wrecked my shit when I was a newbie. Took me like, I don't know, at least a day to, maybe even a couple of days to kill them. I just, yeah, could not work out their attack patterns or anything. And then, I'm pretty sure my weapon would have been just rubbish. It wouldn't have been upgraded, or maybe like plus 3 or something, so I was doing no damage. I would have both of them on me, then they'd start using their flame, and it was an absolute mess. But yeah, I'm gonna call the episode here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time.